Greetings to everyone. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Another day of Sunday wakeboarding, and we went to CWC. Now, we are at Ivan's car and we pick up Nathan and drove us to the wake bar. It's just the three of us. Our true friends Kim and Nandine are not available. Please join us and let's have fun. A huge shout out to all my subscribers and to all who are watching, please subscribe to my channel. We're heading now to CWC. It's another rainy Sunday morning. Jiro likes skateboarding. He enjoys this rather than on the water. I will teach him until he learns on his own. What do you think, guys? Can Jiro learn to operate the skateboard on his own? The weather is very nice today. The water is flat and it's good to ride. It's just difficult if no one sprays water on the obstacle. Because when you spray water on the obstacle, it helps to reduce friction between the wakeboard and the obstacle. This reduction in friction allows the wakeboard to slide more smoothly across the obstacle, making it easier for the wakeboarder to perform tricks and maneuvers. By spraying water on the obstacle, you can help maintain the wakeboarder's speed as they approach and slide across it. This speed is essential for maintaining momentum and completing tricks successfully. Because you know, water acts as a lubricant, reducing the risk of damage to both the wakeboard and their obstacle. Without water, the wakeboarder and the obstacle may experience more wear and tear, leading to potential injuries or damage. So, spraying water on the obstacle can enhance the overall performance of the wakeboarder by ensuring smoother and more controlled movements. This can help the wakeboarder execute tricks and greater precision.
So what are we waiting for? Let's go and watch how good the wakeboarders perform their tricks. Thank you. covered. Kaya mo yan. Hirali ka dito! Manatabaw ka sa tinker na ano,
as usual, after we wakeboard like before, we go to the pool to swim.
Depende. Wow, my splash.
Thank you for watching. Ciao, bella.